My dear students, today we will begin chapter 5, operations on rational numbers. In this chapter, we will study how to do operations on rational numbers. Operations are the operators like plus, minus, multiply, division, and so on. So our today's topic is addition of rational numbers. Now, how we do addition of rational numbers? Before I begin, I request you all to write all the examples in your notebook before doing your classwork and homework. So, addition of rational number. The addition of rational numbers is carried out in the same way as that of addition of fractions. Fractions we have already studied. What we studied, when the fractions were like, it was simple to add them or to subtract them. When they were unlike, what we did? We only used to find the LCM, after that find the equivalent fractions and then solve it. So if two rational numbers are to be added, we should first convert each of them into a rational number with positive denominator. This point you have to keep in mind. Denominator should always be positive. If it is negative, multiply it with minus 1, multiply the rational number with a minus 1 in numerator and denominator and make your denominator positive. Let us take some examples. First one is add 3 by 7 and 56 by 7. This is very easy. An example of like, when the given numbers have same denominator, means kind of like fractions. So like means, since both the denominators are same, we will only add the numerators. So 3 plus 56 by 7, 3 plus 56 is a 59, 59 by 7 in the mixed form is 843 by 7. Second one is add 3 by 13 and minus 5 by 13. So how we will proceed? 3 by 13 plus in the bracket minus 5 by 13. Since both the denominators are same, 3 plus in the bracket minus 5 by 13. Now plus into minus. Plus and minus are getting multiplied here. So in the next step, plus into minus will be a minus. 3 minus 5 by 13. 3 minus 5 is a minus 2. So the final answer is minus 2 by 13. Second case is when denominators of given numbers, actually I am talking about rational numbers. So when denominators of rational numbers are unequal or different. In this case, we take the LCM of their denominators and express each of the given numbers with this LCM as the common denominator. Now we add these numbers as shown in the previous slide. So what we will do? We will find the LCM of the denominators, then change the rational numbers to the equivalent rational numbers having same denominators, and then it is very easy. So look, for example, add 5 by 6 and 7 by 9. So clearly the denominators are different and they are positive, so we don't have to worry. Now the LCM of 6 and 9 is 18. So 5 by 6, you have to change 6 to 18. So how we will change the 6 to 18? 6 into 3 will give you 18. So if you are multiplying the 3 in the denominator, it should be multiplied in numerator. So the number 5 by 6 will become 15 by 18. Same way, 7 by 9 will become 14 by 18. Now here we are multiplying with the 2 up and 2 down, so that the denominator becomes 18. The new numbers are 15 by 18 and 14 by 18. Adding both of them, we got 29 by 18. So the answer is 29 by 18. Its mixed form is 1 whole 11 by 18. One another example, adding 5 by 6 and minus 3 by 7. Again, 6 and 7 are different denominators. Their LCM will be 42. Changing both the rational numbers to their equivalent form, 5 by 6 will become 35 by 42. Minus 3 by 7 will become a minus 18 by 42. Adding 35 and minus 18 together. Now, if you see here again, plus into minus. So plus into minus is a minus. So the final answer is 35 minus 18 by 42. 35 minus 18 is a 17. and we get the answer as 17 by 18. Let us see some questions of your exercise 5.1 from page 64. This is also your classwork. The first question given is, add the following rational numbers. 3 by 7 and minus 6 by 7. What kind of rational numbers are they? These are the like ones. Simply adding 3 plus minus 6. Now plus and minus together will give us 3 minus 6. So 3 minus 6 by 7 will be a minus 3 by 7. Question number 2. Add the following rational numbers. Second part is given as 1 and 5 by minus 12. So here neither they are like nor the denominator is positive. So how we will proceed? 1 in the rational or the fraction form can be written as 1 by 1, right? How we can write 5? 5 can be written as 5 by 1. So 1 is written as 1 by 1 plus in the bracket 5 by minus 12. And I always repeat that the denominator should be positive. So what we will do? Since 1 as fraction is 1 by 1 and 5 by minus 12, with a positive denominator will be minus 5 by 12. I hope you remember how we have done, how 5 by 12 became a minus 5 by 12. 5 by minus 12 when multiplied with a minus 1 up and minus 1 down will give you a minus 5 by 12. Clear? This will be done. So let's erase all these things. They are not required. So 5 by minus 12 became minus 5 by 12. LCM is 12. Now 1 by 1 plus of minus 5 by 12 is 12 by 12 plus of minus 5 by 12. Now 12 plus of minus 5 will be 12 minus 5. And the final answer is 7 by 12. Third one, 5 by minus 26 plus 8 by 39. So again, you have to make the denominator as a positive one. So what you will do, you will multiply with the minus 1 up and minus 1 down. 5 by minus 26 will become minus 5 by 36. So the new number is minus 5 by 26 plus 8 by 39. 26 and 39 are two unlike terms, so their LCM will be 78. Now minus 5 by 26 plus 8 by 39 will be minus 15 by 78 plus 16 by 78. How I have done? You can see the above steps. So minus 15 plus 16 divided by 78. One is minus here, one is plus here. When two different signs are together, we always do the minus. So it is minus 15 plus 16 will be 1 by 78. Fourth, second part, this is a mixed kind of question where we have three different rational numbers, 9 by minus 26 plus 14 by 39 plus minus 5 by minus 13. So our first target should be to change all denominators to positive, making all denominators positive. We get the new set of rational numbers as minus 9 by 26 plus 14 by 39 plus 5 by 13. Either you can change in minus 5 by minus 13, you can cancel both the negative terms, or you can multiply with the minus 1 up and minus 1 down, you will get the same answer. Now three different terms here are 26, 39 and 13. So the LCM of the denominators 26, 39 and 13 is 78. Now changing accordingly so that the denominators become same, we got the new numbers as minus 27 by 78 plus 28 by 78 plus 30 by 78. On solving all of them, we get the final answer as 31 by 78. See, here only the things, operations of integers are involved, and we have already studied integers. So just take care of this part. If you have any doubt, please ask me. Now it's your homework time. From the same exercise and from same page 64, your today's homework is question number 1, sub part 3, question number 2, sub part 1, question number 3, sub part 1, question number 4, first and third part. So all in all, 5 questions for today's homework. Thank you. Have a nice day.